Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. And today you can see I'm in a forest, Royal Forest, where I've been many times before. Well, the weather is very changing today. Then there's sun and then there's rain. So I'm glad I have my Kimber tarp with me and can put that up and stay in here and not get wet. But this little video is about several things. I'm going to prepare a little meal and of course my coffee, and then I have got a new stuff, a new gear that I would like to show to you. And last but not least, I have made a DIY project again. I love making those projects, and I've made a little video how I did it. So I hope you enjoy and like. But now I'm going to light a fire and begin to prepare my meal. So hang on. And I think I'll start to show you this. It's a bush box, yes, from Bushcraft Essential, and I've got such one, but they offered me very kindly to send me one of titanium, and that's cool. It is very lightweight and durable, and I'm going to try it out now for the first time. I guess it's like the old one, but this one I'm going to begin use when I'm out in the woods and prepare my meal and coffee. I think for a change I'll use this, and it's much more like a bonfire when I have fire in this one. So, but first of all, oh, it's stuck in here. Yeah, I have this. It's actually a windscreen. Yeah, you can see it there, from Tatonka, and I cut it out, and when I place it there, I don't get the grass burned. And then my little bush box. I love it. I used it many times, and it's really cool. This one is from the old one that I have. I don't know if I can get this in titanium, but I can use this if I'm going to prepare some meat or other things on top of the fire. But I have to find some wood, some dry wood, so I can light it up. Hang on.
And it's been raining for a couple of days, so everything is wet. So I think I'll go in here under the large trees and see if I can find some dry wood.
Yeah, it's dry. Yeah, and I was a little bit lucky because I found a dead birch tree under a large spruce, so these are completely dry inside and not so wet outside. I'm going to prepare it now. And of course I have my birch bark that I collected earlier. now it's time for coffee and for me to show you my new DIY project. And it is this one. Yes. What is it? Well, it's a pouch. Because I have my solar stove in that great bag from P&W Bushcraft, and I don't bring the solar stove with me, I had to make a new pouch for my little kettle. So this is how it turned out. This is a, call it Turkish nuts, I made. You know, I'm an old sailor, so this hold it tight so it doesn't slip out. And then take this one out and just open it here. And inside I have my little kettle, and my kettle is in this little scarf because it gets dirty when I use it. So this one will take most of the dirt. But this is my new pouch for my Eagle products, 0.7 liters kettle.
Yeah, now, and this little pouch I made back home, and I would like to show you how. So here's my DIY, how I made this little pouch. Hope you enjoy.
Yeah, and this was the first time I used my titanium bush box from Bushcraft Essential, and you saw I put them in 10 packs, and you can actually do that, but I forgot that here on the back side there are these you can take off and put over here so you can put things on. But I first realized that when the stove was very hot, so I didn't want to burn my hands by taking these out, so I used the 10 packs instead. But it's a great stove. I love it. It's very efficient, and when it's very hot you can burn everything on it, even a little bit damp wood. So I love it, and I'll begin using this when I'm out on my hikes. I think it's making a little bit more like a bonfire, and that's great. Well folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video, and thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I hope you're having a nice weekend, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.